Hey, hi, hello everyone. It's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new. Today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you all the polishes that I purchased in June. Yes, I purchased more polishes that I did not need to purchase. We're going to start off with one that I purchased in a D-stash. But before we get started, I want to let you know what I'm wearing on my nails. This is Polish for Days in Fluorescent from the Day Glow collection. And this is the Crystalline Diamond Top Coat from Polish for Days that I bought last year. I bought both of these last year. That's what I'm wearing on my nails. Don't love it, don't hate it. It's just okay. I feel like I should put some background music of the angels singing and somebody saying, hallelujah. For this polish, this is Wildflower Lacquer in Dancing in the Clouds. I'm so excited. This is from the Sparkle and Shine box of August of 2023, the box that got away, the unicorn box. You know how they say, you know, the one that got away is your unicorn? This was my unicorn box. Oh my gosh, so I have all three polishes now, as I should have always had. I should have always had these polishes in my collection. I'm so glad that I have them now. I'm happy, so freaking happy. This looks fabulous and I love it. And yes, this is my new favorite. And I got this from my friend Amy Sue. She was gonna de-stash it and she saw me mention it in the video and she said, I think I have the polish, you want it? And I was like, yes. So I bought it from her. She's such a sweetheart. Thank you so much, Amy Sue. You do not know how happy you made me. And then she's a little sneak because she actually sent me this fresh paint polish in Aurora. Yeah, Aurora. And oh my God, how freaking beautiful is this polish? I don't think I have any fresh paint. I think I used to have fresh paint. No, I don't think I ever bought fresh paint. I don't know. I don't remember, but I know the brand. I've seen it. I think it's Five Below. But this is gorgeous. She knows my taste. She knows me so well. Next is a polish from Orly, and this is in Tangerine Dream. Now, this is part of the collection that came out with Plastic Jungle, if I'm not mistaken. Am I remembering that correctly? But I saw this at either a TJ Maxx or Marshall's or a Ross. I don't know. I went shopping in Florida. I found this, had to buy it. Why do I do this? I don't know if I told y'all, but I went to Florida again for the weekend of the 29th and 30th just to drop off my kids at their abuela's house in Florida. And I was there for like less than 24 hours, honestly, but I had enough time to go shopping in the morning. and so I found this one and I had to get it because I loved it. It just called to me. So the next three polishes are polishes that I was inspired to purchase by a couple of nail polish friends. But this one in particular, I was inspired to purchase from Krista at Restored by Polish on Instagram and here on YouTube. This is Morgan Taylor in Tag You're It. She talked about this polish on her Instagram rather recently, I think for the month of June. And it was so beautiful. She said it was her new favorite summer polish. And I was like, what is this? Now, the reason why I was so intrigued, because when I saw her like polish in motion video, it looked so similar to one of my favorite summer polishes, which is Orly's O Cabana Boy. And so I had to get it. Now, they are very, very similar. However, I will say the Orly Cabana Boy looks a little bit deeper pink, like a deeper hot pink. On camera, they look pretty much dead on dupes, but the Morgan Taylor Tag You're It is a little bit lighter, and there is the same kind of shimmer, but not as much as in O Cabana Boy. But so happy to have this one though, because if it's similar enough, I have to do a comparison. Y'all know I have to do a comparison. But if it's similar enough, I won't have to stress out about using this, my Orly O Cabana Boy, if they're similar enough that, because this one is discontinued. Like, I don't see it. It's not on their website. It's not on there. Or at least it wasn't when I checked last. And I don't see it when you go to like stores. I don't see it on the shelves. So I need this in my life for always. If this is a good dupe, super happy. And I love Morgan Taylor. Like, they're such a good brand. This next Morgan Taylor is called Flying Out Loud. And I believe that I was inspired to buy this from Rachel from Polish with Ray when she talked about it in her Summer Rack. One of her videos. I want to say she talked about this polish, and she said that it was a like summer or springtime version of your Prugly, like a Prugly but for the summer, and I was like, I need it. Sight unseen, in real life, I need this. And so I got this one as well. I actually ordered these two at Beyond Polish. And then I also purchased this one from Morgan Taylor, and this one is called Got Some Altitude. I don't know why. I don't know who inspired for me to get this. I don't know who inspired me to get this. I don't know why I got this. Like, I'm looking at it and I'm just like, why did I get this? This is so not a polish I'm in the mood for right now. It's pretty. It's like a mauve-y, dusty, like grandma shade. What Josephine from Polish Talk calls a grandma shade. It's pretty. It's just not what I'm in the mood for. So I'm really surprised that I purchased this. I can't remember who inspired me. Maybe I saw it swatched and thought, oh my gosh, I love this. But I can't remember who it was if I did. And, or maybe I saw it in a video and again thought the same thing. I don't know. But it's, I don't know. This one's not doing it for me right now. We'll see how, if and when I wear it, I like it. And then I have Polish for Days that I purchased. Let me get them out of the box. I bought the entirety of the Night Glow collection, but we're gonna start off with the toppers. This first one is in the Stars. This is a reflective glitter topper with black flakes or glitter in there. Oh my gosh, so freaking cute. I can't, I'm so happy with this topper. Next topper is called Light Out, and I believe that this is just a black flaky or small flaky topper. The reason why I got this, I have Rogue Lacquer's Batsy, and it is just too jam-packed. And even after I decanted it and added, you know, separated into two different bottles, added a little bit more base to try to sheer it out a little bit, it's still very, very, very opaque, or a lot of payoff in one stroke, which normally I would say fantastic, but not when I'm trying to use it as a topper. So I purchased this one. I generally get a black flaky topper if I think it's going to give me a little bit of a sparser look, because I'm trying to differentiate it with from my Rogue. So I bought this. Yeah. And now for the star of the collection, or for the star of the haul and the collection itself, this is Polish for Days in Nova Melon from the Night Glow collection. This color, whew, lordy. Okay, I'm gonna do a real quick comparison with what I'm wearing right now, which is Fluorescent. And I think I like the Night Glow collection a little bit better already, because it has that blue shimmer, whereas the Day Glow collection has that orangey gold shimmer, which warms up the color, and this one doesn't. So this one already is like, I love it. I am so happy. So I'm gonna be wearing this one. I'm adding all of these Polish for Days into my polish rack, even though it's already July, and I just have 2 months, July and August, to wear my summer colors. So I don't know how to say this in English, so I'm gonna say, me tengo que poner la pila. So I need to, like, come on, get the battery going, like get the motor running. Maybe that's what the translation of that. Anyways, so love this. Can't wait to wear it. Next we have Polish for Day in Moonlit. And oh, it says topper on here. Say what? Is this a topper? Wait, is this a topper or a typo? Because it does not look... Yeah, that is not a topper at all. So I think it's just a typo, not a topper, for this one. Oh, I was out of focus. I don't know how long I was out of focus, but basically all I was saying is that this is a typo. It says topper on it, but it's not. Beautiful. Next, we have Polish for Days in Baja Blasted. And this is so pretty. This actually kind of reminds me a little bit of, well, a lighter version of the Dreamland Lacquer Shake Your Shamrock. God, that polish is gorgeous. But this one looks a little bit like muted compared to that one in my head. I don't know. Let me go look at the bottle real quick. You cannot do a proper comparison in your head, because they never come out exactly how you thought. I thought that this Dreamland Lacquer, I thought that this Polish for Days reminded me of the Dreamland Lacquer, but now having them together, yeah, no. I mean, they're similar enough, but there's definitely more blue shimmer in this one, and it definitely leans a little bit bluer in the base, more, I don't know, tealy, I guess. This one is like green. Why am I out of focus? This is really, really green. with a shimmer. It's gorgeous. I need to wear this. Next, we have Polish for Days in Glow Stick. And this is a like lime green. Like, see, this is kind of like the blue. I feel like this is the blue and this is the green of the collection. And Glow Stick is not that, no, they're not similar. I mean, they're similar, but they're not the same. So I'm glad I have both. But this Glow Stick is just freaking gorgeous. Yeah, I think I like the Night Glow collection a little bit better, honestly. I'm not gonna lie. And the final polish that I have to share is Polish for Days in Astro Bright. And this is a bright orange with these beautiful shimmer. Like, this doesn't have the blue shimmer. This has like a pink to gold shimmer in it. Whew, so, so pretty. Love it. All right, those are all the polishes that I purchased in the month of June, I believe. I don't remember buying anything else. But anyhow, but that was a lot, so it doesn't matter. Thank you all so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye!